Hey everyone, welcome to another episode of Model Railroad Operations and the second part in these couple of videos covering two op sessions at the La Mesa Model Railroad Club in San Diego. In this video, we'll be covering my attendance of a 1970s themed operating session as opposed to their more well-known 1950s operating sessions. This, of course, models the SP in Santa Fe in the 1970s and all the various power and equipment therein. I still quite enjoyed this, and everything ran with the same timetable and train order rules as the previous 1950s session. Only difference is slightly newer equipment. So without further ado, let's get right into it. The first train I ran was a westbound Santa Fe reefer train between Mojave and Bakersfield. And in this next shot, my reefer train is in the hole at Allard for the passing of the westbound San Francisco Chief. Now, you will notice that the passenger trains on the layout are more reminiscent of those that would have been found in the 1960s than the 1970s. Of course, by the 1970s, in real life, there were no passenger trains running over Tehachapi, except for the very occasional detour of Amtrak's Coast Starlight. Now, the reason for these trains from the previous decades running on this layout and being in the timetable is that the club really just wanted to justify running these trains in the first place. So, they came up with a little bit of alternate history in regards to the formation of Amtrak. Instead of, in our reality, where Amtrak was formed as its own sole rail company, in the version of events at the La Mesa Club, Amtrak was founded instead as a funding agency that gave the freight railroads incentive to keep their passenger trains running. And that is why you will see the San Francisco Chief and the San Joaquin Daylight running over the layouts. With that being said, here is the San Francisco Chief grounding the curve at Caliente. And while I'm still in the hole, here comes an SP TOFC train coming uphill. And with the reefer train terminated in Bakersfield, it's time for my next assignment, which is to run Santa Fe train 199 westbound over the railroad. And Santa Fe 199, if you're familiar with your Santa Fe train symbols, was the hottest train on the Santa Fe Railroad. It was known as the Super C. And it ran an expedited schedule at passenger train speeds from Chicago to the Bay Area. So here we are, rounding the curve into Waylong and traversing the loop. And further up the line at Rowan, we duck into the siding for a meet with the eastbound San Joaquin Daylight, which is coming up the hill at Cliff. And waiting for us in the hole at Beelville is a hopper train with run through Union Pacific and Trona Railway power heading for the plant at Trona. Now almost back at Bakersfield, we see the eastbound San Francisco Chief passing Magunda. And now it's time for yet another westbound, this time the longest train I ran during the session, which was an empty Santa Fe grain train heading over the mountain into the San Joaquin Valley. At Tehachapi, we wait for an eastbound manifest before receiving new orders for a run downhill. Thank you. Next, a way-long sighting, we get a good view of the full train as it rounds Tehachapi. And we now jump to day two, where we see the same train, now loaded, heading eastbound through Beelville, this time with a pair of manned helper units midway through the train. Once again at Waylong, we round to Tehachapi Loop, again passing another Santa Fe manifest with plenty of run-through power. And with the grain train successfully terminated at Mojave, it's time to run SP San Joaquin Daylight eastbound over the railroad.
And we are going to wait. This is smoke. It's on fire.
Once again at Waylong, the San Joaquin Daylight passes an impressive unit train of sugar beets heading westbound. And lastly, we see Santa Fe train 199 again heading west towards Richmond, California, passing Waylong. And with the Super C passing through Illman, that concludes this coverage of the 70s Obsession at the La Mesa Club. Thank you all very much for watching, and I hope you've enjoyed the video. Stay tuned for my coverage of the National Narrow Gauge Convention in Denver, Colorado. Again, thank you all for watching.